Hello, this is Boyan. Today we will talk about closing periods in Sage 300 CRE. Different modules in 300 CRE have a different closing procedures. Some of them don't have a closing procedure, month closing procedure at all. So in order to get a reference to which modules would deploy month-end closing procedure, I suggest that you go to Sage Desktop, Additional Tools, and launch Monthly Task Workflow Center. In the middle of the screen, you'll get a breakdown of applications that may or may not have a monthly closing procedure, as well as a status being a current month for each one of those applications that do have a monthly closing procedure available. You will notice that this Monthly Task Workflow Center does not have a reference to year-end closing procedure. We'll talk about year-end for each module as we go down the list. Let's start with accounts payable. As per Monthly Task Workflow Center, accounts payable module does not have a monthly closing procedure. However, if you expand accounts payable application, we'll see that under task, there are two options down at the bottom, closing a year and closing a 1099 year. In accounts payable fiscal year end for that module, and a close 1099 year may not be same dates. Your fiscal year end can be in any month of the year, whereas your 1099 should always be December 31st in the current year. Closing a year in accounts payable, closing a fiscal year in accounts payable, will lock your period-to-date purchases and period-to-date payment amounts, aggregate them to the vendor level, and report them as a single value. By closing a year, all current payments and all current purchases will be locked in the prior year purchases and payments, and a new year data bucket will be open. Close 1099 year, however, on the other side, will solidify or lock payments to the vendor that are subject to 1099 reporting. Those two processes, those two year closing processes, are performed independently. So you could technically close your fiscal year without closing your 1099 year and the other way around. Let's move on to accounts receivable. Again, another module that does not have a monthly closing procedure. However, if you open accounts payable module, expand the task section, you'll notice that there's a year-end process available in accounts receivable. This process, similar to accounts payable, will close year-to-date billings, cash receipts into single value accumulated to the customer level, and it will open a data bucket for the next year after year-end closing is finished. Next, let's look at the contracts, job cost, and we'll come back to payroll and the GL last. So on the contracts module, we do have a monthly closing procedure. We do not have a year-end closing procedure in the contract module, however. So let's open the contracts and let's have a look options available under tasks. So you'll notice that we have only one option, and that option is to close a month. This becomes very important for users that use a progress billing in a billing module. There's quite often a case where we have tickets, support tickets open from the billing module where previous billings do not show total billings to date. And typically that will be the case where your billing is happening in, let's say, month of June, but your contracts are still sitting in the month of May. So your accumulated billings to date are not updated before month in a contract is closed. So typically that would be the remedy for this particular scenario. Close a month in a contract and carry on with your billing. You would typically try to keep your job cost and contracts months the same. Typically, those two applications will have a same current month, which obviously is not the case in my example. So moving on, if you look at the job cost module, we'll see there's a month-end procedure available. And if you open a job cost, you'll notice that we have a close month option there. In my case, you can also see close week, which is a little bit unusual scenario. We can set up a period in job cost to be weekly, in which case it would require closing periods each week. Untypical. In most of the cases, you're going to only see close month option available in a job cost. Again, similar to the contracts, this process is run at the month end, but importance of closing month in job cost goes a little bit beyond one in a contracts module. In job cost, closing a month will lock or solidify your month-to-date cost and billing in data buckets extended down from job to extra to cost code to category level. By closing a month, that current month becomes a previous month, new monthly bucket opens up, and a future monthly buckets open up as well. It's very important for users that use those aggregate values, month-to-date billing or month-to-date costs for reporting purposes. So controlling of timing of closing month and job costs can become very important. You will notice that job cost does not have a year-end closing procedure. So basically closing a last period in a fiscal year-end setup for job cost module will close a year in a job cost as well. So closing a last month in a period will lock that year-to-date cost and year-to-date billing to the prior year cost and prior year billing, and it will open new data buckets for the next year. Let's look at the payroll next. Payroll has a both month and year-end closing procedure. There are two important dates in payroll that we have to bear in mind. The first one is period end date and the other one check date. So payroll system can be configured where either period end date or check date can be used as a posting dates to your GL. However, when it comes to government withholdings, only check date will matter. So tax calculation, any withholdings are calculated based on a check date, regardless to your payroll settings. So bear in mind, if you have your settings in a payroll setup where your period end date is your posting date, at the year end, you may have some discrepancies or some reconciliation to perform, knowing that your check date can potentially go into the next year for a period that's ending in this calendar year. So something to keep in mind. Another thing that's going to happen with the closing a month in payroll, actually we can click on that and see how it looks like, is that your monthly or month-to-date earnings, deductions, fringes, and taxes will be set to zero and new month will open. So for the new month. So if any of the calculations are based on a cap month-to-date amounts, once you close your period, once you close a month in payroll, all those amounts will start calculating again until next month cap amount is reached. Something to keep in mind. Also, if you have a scenario so where your period end date finishes in a current payroll period, but your check date is in the next period. Example, your period end date May 31st, but your check date is dated as a June 1st. If your payroll period remains as a May, those checks will print, but they will not post to job cost and GL. In such case, you would have to close your month in a payroll and do posting of those checks again. On the other side, year-end closing procedure in payroll will basically close your payroll year, and you will be able only to close a payroll year if your current month is the last month in a calendar year. You noticed a minute ago that my payroll is in month of May. I'm trying to run year-end closing process in a payroll. The system will not allow me to do this until I get to the period 12, month 12, in which case I will be able to close my year and move into the next year. So what's going to happen with the year-end closing procedure? All your year-to-date earnings, deductions, fringes, taxes will be locked in something called prior year earnings, deductions, taxes, and fringes, and new year-to-date amounts will be opened with a zero value. So basically, closing a year in a payroll will reset your year-to-dates to zero. It will open new data buckets for the new calendar year, payroll year, and everything that was calculated up to this point of time becomes prior year earnings, taxes, deductions, or fringes. This also has a direct impact on the application of new tax tables, new tax rates, that usually are available at the beginning of the calendar year. So if your check date starts in a new fiscal year, your tax tables need to be updated before that payroll that will be paid in the next calendar year is calculated. So, timing of uploads or downloads rather and changes to your tax tables is very critical as it relates to closing year in a payroll. So again, please bear in mind that your tax calculation is triggered by check date. So if you're performing payroll in a current year, knowing that your check date will be in the next year, your tax tables need to be updated before that payroll is processed. And lastly, let's look at the general ledger. GL has a both month-end and year-end closing procedure. If you open a GL, expand the tasks section, you'll see that we have those three options on the bottom. close current period, open close posting period, and close fiscal year. So let's look at every one of them. If you launch close period, the system will launch this wizard that will walk you through the period closing process. The first screen will ask you if you performed backup of your GL master file. We have separate videos on the processes when and how to perform backup of the system. This is one of those videos that you probably would like to review before start doing your month-end closing procedure or year-end closing procedure in a CH300 CRE. Once you confirm and say yes, otherwise you will not be able to move forward, you'll be able to click on the next screen and select which companies or prefixes you'd like to perform closing process. So closing selected prefixes will allow you to pick or cherry pick companies that you'd like to close. Clicking on the next screen will take you to the periods to advance drop-down menu. Highly recommended to never change this number from 1. Even if you need to close multiple periods, we would recommend that you run this process multiple times, as many times as it takes to close to the period that you'd like to get to, rather than advancing those numbers. Once you advance those numbers, it's a reversible process. You cannot go back and reopen those periods in any way. You'll click on Next and click on Finish to complete the process. GL would have to be free of any user locks before you can complete this process. So typically this is after hours. This is something that you would do after hours. Once month is closed, you have option to reopen that period. So GL task open close posting period will take you to the screen where you can pick particular company. It will give you a list of all available periods and you can uncheck ones that you want to make up entries to all the periods have been closed. So again, unchecking those boxes will just allow you to get to those periods, make entries and post them from there. Checking those boxes is not closing period. Closing period is already completed. This is just giving you option to get to that period or not. Once you make changes to that closed period, please come back here and put a checkbox where it was and move forward from there. So on this screen here, checking boxes in the future does not perform month-end closing process. It only opens or closes a period for the purpose of posting in previously closed period. The only proper way to close period in CH300 CRE is to go through the screen that we described before. So close current period, that's the only way to properly close period in the CH300 CRE. And finally, closing a fiscal year end in GL. So we'll go to GL, task, close a fiscal year, agree with the backup question. Again, please watch our videos on when and how to perform full backup or partial backup of CH300 CRE. Pick a company that you're closing. You'll pick one that has actually period end date to be equal to fiscal year end. Important thing to remember here, if you were to pick company where current period is not at the fiscal year end, you will not be able to perform that closing. So if you pick company 10 where period ending date is February and fiscal year end is December, we will not be able to make closing process completed because we are not at the end of the fiscal year. So we would have to pick another entity. Let's pick one where we have period end date that's equal to fiscal year end date, which is company 21 in this case. We will say okay, and on the next screen, the system will display our retained earnings account and it will provide the value that will get closed into retained earnings. My demo data here, it's not really the greatest out there, so I have no earnings, no expenses in the current year, therefore my retained earnings will not change. However, in the regular circumstances, this number would read actual changes to retained earnings. So year-end closing procedure will close out all P&L accounts. It will restate retained earnings and move your fiscal year forward by 1 year. CH300 CRE will allow reopening period in a prior fiscal year and making entry, adjusting entries to those closed periods. Once those changes are made, it's mandatory to perform year-end process again. That is the only way of how retained earnings can be restated properly. So technically, you don't have to wait 3, 4, 5, 6 months for your CPA to deliver your adjusting entries. you can close your fiscal year end in Sage 300 CRE when you're ready, move forward with your financial statements, and once you receive your adjusting entries, you can open that last period of the last fiscal year, make adjusting entries, and rerun your close year process, which will restate your retained earnings and which point of time you're going to republish your financial statements. So this was a quick review on closing periods and year in Sage 300 CRE. Thank you for watching.